Hello everyone, this is Team Cat Mode and here we have the Oppo F1 Plus with us, a phone which is called as a selfie expert by the company in its official website. The main reason behind this is the 16 megapixel front facing camera that has the capacity to take a lot of quality selfies. Now this is a configuration that's massive when compared to the primary 13 megapixel shooter. So not only in terms of camera, but this phone also has a lot number of individual specs and features that are worth a praise. So let's find out if Oppo has been successful in placing all this together to give us a better smartphone experience. Coming to the build and design aspect, the very first thing that will come to your mind when you have a first glance at this phone is the striking resemblance with the very well-known iPhone 6s. On the back, we have the Oppo label shining and this is impressive. The sides are well trimmed. On the front, we have the sensor, the speaker and the 16 megapixel front cam. And towards the down, we have the capacitive buttons and the fingerprint sensor. Now the fun fact is that this also weighs as the iPhone 6s. That is 145 grams straight. Gradually flipping towards the right hand side, we can see the presence of a SIM card slot just above the power button. Now this being a dual SIM phone can accommodate two SIMs at a time, but this is a hybrid slot, which means slot number 1 will have a nano SIM and slot number 2 will have either a SIM card or a micro SD card. Towards the left hand side is the volume rocker. The back has parallel antenna bands that run along both the bottom and the top with the protruding rounded camera in the top left corner. The primary camera being a 13 megapixel shooter has a dual tone flash housed just below it. On the top we have the noise cancellation port which is effective to some extent in cancelling the external noises. Towards the bottom we have the 3.5mm jack, the USB port and the speakers, and this looks exactly the way it is in the iPhone 6. Speaking about the software on which this phone runs, like all Oppo phones, the F1 Plus has the company's own custom Color OS software. While this device boots up, let's have a look at the specifications. The screen, as said before, is a 5.5 inch Full HD with 73.9 screen to body ratio, which is pretty much impressive. The processor is an octa-core processor that belongs to MediaTek. It has an internal storage of 64GB that is expandable up to 128GB. That means you will get enough of space for all your files. The RAM is 4GB and the GPU is a Mali. The battery is 2850 mAh, and this comes with a fast charging option, which means 75% of the total charge will be covered in the first 30 minutes. The operating system is a ColorOS 3.0 that is based on Android 5.1. The icon layout is pretty much simple like the ones we have seen in the iOS, and there is no noticeable lag when the transition is made from one screen to other. Speaking about the special feature of gestures and fingerprint, this can be accessed through the settings, wherein you have a predefined set of gestures that can be made on a locked screen. This can be made to unlock the screen the way you want it to unlock. For example, if you knock on it, it will get unlocked. Or else if you put a slash, it will unlock. If you put an O on it, the camera app will open directly. Or else if you put a V on it, the flashlight will open on directly. Speaking of the fingerprint sensor function, this can also be accessed through the settings. Oppo's fingerprint sensor is inside the home button, which actually functions as a button as well, just like the one in Apple's iPhone. It promises to unlock the phone in just 0.2 seconds. This is really, really fast. The sensor is also very accurate and steady fast. Also, it refuses to give a false reading. Now this feature will make us love the ability to press the home button and go straight to the home screen from a black lock screen in double the time. Talking about the cameras of the phone, there is one thing for sure that you won't be disappointed. 13 megapixel primary camera click great pictures in well lit conditions. The camera app offers multiple shooting modes such as double exposure and expert. It also offers a number of filters that you can use to enhance your images. In good daylight, the images often come out sharp, with nice tone and in detail. Details are sharp, especially when you get close up to a subject. However, it does struggle to get some focus. In low light, it does struggle a little. And once lighting is less than optimal, you will notice some noise and graininess creeping in. Like a lot of phones out nowadays though, there is a minimal camera mode called Expert mode, which lets you adjust the shutter speed to compensate. As you can see in the sample pictures, these have come up excellently with a vivid description of the color. There is no pixelation when you zoom in, and the detail which is captured is very much precise. There is an effective beauty mode that compensates for the error slightly. It uses two adjustment settings, to change the skin tone and smooth out the lines. The quality of the detail captured can be seen in this pic, where you can see each and every strand of this caterpillar. And this is a sample video shot from the back camera. So the final verdict is that if you are looking out for a selfie oriented camera phone, do give the Oppo F1 Plus a try, because this won't be disappointing you. This is a complete package that you have been waiting for.